What are we doing today?
We're at my summer camp, and this is the last day. I'm going to be a mommy, and I'm playing Cinderella.
Look at that pretty dress.
I have to change my shoes.
Okay.
Here's Emily's wand. And she's putting on her shoes.
I think I don't.
That's so cute.
We now present Applause Studios' curtain call, Cinderella Camp's production of Cinderella. Cinderella worked so very hard. She never got to play. She had to sew and clean and cook and scrub and toil all day. Her stepmom and stepsisters, sadly, each one was a jerk. They never helped that tired girl with any of the work. She had no bed to sleep in. Just the floor down by the fire. So her clothes were always dirty. She got her name from her attire. One day a proclamation was pronounced throughout the land. It seemed a very formal ball by royalty was planned. The king and queen decided that the prince should find a bride. So they invited all the girls from across the countryside. Yay! Cinderella was excited because she thought she'd get to go. But when the mom and sisters heard, they hollered,
No!
For you will be too busy helping us to look our best. You have no time, you have no gown. Good luck, you know the rest. So poor sad Cinderella fixed their hair and helped them dress. And then they left her quite alone. And she was such a mess. She sat right down and cried because her heart was filled with woe. She sighed, I wish that to the ball I somehow now could go. No sooner had she said it than a light filled up the room. A happy fairy godmother soon chased away her gloom. There, she said to Cinderella, sobbing on the floor. I'm here to grant your wish, my dear. Don't blow anymore. I'll wave my magic wand, you see, and quicker than a wink. I'll change this cup into a coach. And then what do you think? I'll change two mice to horses. And last of all, it will not do to send you to the ball in a dress so torn and dirty. No, it will not do at all. And suddenly, Cinderella's dirty rags were gone. To the ball, their Cinderella went. And when she walked in the room, the prince just gasped and stared at her while his heart went zoom, zoom, zoom. He danced with only her all night. And soon they fell in love. Cinderella forgot to check the time until the clock tower up above began to chime at midnight. Bong! I must go, she screamed, then zipped across the room and up the stairs until she kind of slipped. One shoe fell off. Oh, well, she cried, I'll have to leave it there. The clock is chiming. I must race right home, for what I wear will soon turn back to rags, and all this other stuff as well will be just like it was before my godmother cast her spell. And sure enough, the last loud bong just as the girl arrived at home at the end of her frantic flight. The prince, he looked around in shock. Where did she go? He cried. He didn't know how to find that girl. Well, that missing shoe he spied. I know, he shouted. Then he called his helpers to his side. Find the girl who fits the shoe, and she shall be my bride. So first thing in the morning, the perfect foot hunt did begin. They knocked on every single door and invited themselves in. Each foot they found was either way too big or way too small. As the sun went down, they feared they'd never find that foot at all. The last house that they came to, can you guess? It was the one where Cinders lived with sisters number two and number one. Mom, of course, who was so sure the shoe would fit her daughters. She didn't call the Cinder Girl to join them like she ought her. The sisters' feet were much too big, though they pushed with all their might. So the sad prince and his helpers turned away, till he caught sight of a lovely face a-peeking through a crack in a nearby door. Who is this? Oh, no one special, answered Mom with a fearful roar. You must join us. Try the shoe on, said the prince to that lovely face. And so she did. And can you guess? Her foot slid perfectly into place. The hearts of Prince and Cindy sang with joy up to the rafters, while Mom and sisters pouted, while you know who had happily ever afters. The end. Thank you.